definitely more special. We have a lot of technology on the cars. We have a visibility of the brand so that we can communicate motorsport as something that we come from motorsport into serial development. My personal highlight is also here that we have motorsport people from all over the world here. And so as a motorsport team, we work as one global team here, and I'm very, very happy and proud about this.
So what Bosch Motorsport does for the teams and manufacturers at track is we're monitoring telemetry data for them. We receive logging data that we review, and we definitely assist them if there is any issue to resolve it.
In general, we support a lot of classes here. You can say that's also a little bit of Bosch race. So you have on one hand the hypercars here with our hybrid system that are the LMDh cars. Then we have the GT class where you see a lot of Bosch parts inside. Therefore, we are happy to be here. And therefore, we are also a bit more excited than in other races.
The achievement for endurance racing was definitely to introduce the first spec hybrid system based on high voltage, so high performing. And I think that changed really endurance racing with the LMDh regulations. The second season of LMDh is actually really positive. In the first season, we had still some issues we had to resolve. For the second season, everything stabilized quite a lot.
Well, the LMDh concept is very, very interesting platform because it enables you to play in the big category without having to bear the enormous development costs of such a car.
We chose the LMDh because basically is an interesting program. For us, it's the first hybrid car in the history. We have the support of Bosch that help us with all the electronic and hybrid devices.
So the collaboration between Alpine Racing and Bosch Motorsport has been existing for a long time across all our motorsport projects, and so far we're quite happy with the support we get from Bosch.
It's not the first time that we work with Bosch, because also on the other program, like the GT3, we are using Bosch devices, and we are improving the system, the strategies and so on in a very close collaboration.
The two additional teams and the development and the work with them gave us a good insight where the challenges are for new teams entering LMDh. And therefore, we really saw where are the hard parts for them to learn and to start running an LMDh car.
There's LMDh car, they are very technical, you know, they are very sophisticated. And of course, we have all this hybrid and energy that we have to manage. It's very interesting for us as a driver because on the technical side, it can help us on many aspects of the track, you know, straight line, of course, for the power, but also to manage the chassis control inside the corner.
Everything is quite well optimized and quite well developed. In order for us, that in terms of drivability, we don't really feel a difference like compared to a normal race car.
The hypercar is so special because I think is for us, especially the LMH, is the hybrid system. Yeah, it's not a skin, he's come back to, let me say, show his long heritage in the race, because you know he was a old manufacturer, that he was one of the first Italian manufacturers to take a part of the race. And he's, I think it's is a good right way to figure out that the will to go for, let me say, entry in this new category.
Our role was that we provide a lot of components into the vehicle, and we developed the whole software for the hybrid part, as well as the functional safety for the car.
I would say 90% of the car is managing by the Bosch staff, including hardware and software. And the challenge, firstly, is a challenge with the innovation. Innovation is always a challenging, and build know-how in the right way to give a good approach in the future. collaboration was good. We had a good feeling with all the guys. They give us always answer very quickly, and I would say in the high level.
Our knowledge and components are not only used and introduced in LMDh or hypercar class, but for sure Bosch does also support LMGT3 OEMs and vehicles.
Yeah, the LMGT3 category is a category which started only this year. It has, compared to the other GT3 categories, it has slight adaptations which are introduced for Le Mans.
Normally we run this car in several environments all over the world, from low-level customer racing until the top-level racing like we do in Le Mans here. The main challenges are to adapt the car and the systems and all the electronics to the requirements we have from the series. So main focus on our side is all the scrutineering system we run in the car. We have to run the drive shaft torque sensors in the car, which we need to control our power on it.
So the biggest challenge this year, I think, for all manufacturers has been the adoption of the torque axles and then adapting the rest of the technology on the car and the engine control to maximize that system. So the controls on the car are pivotal to getting the most out of the vehicle. So working in conjunction with Bosch Motorsports and the electronics that are installed in the car help us maximize those controls.
All the systems which come from Bosch and all the hardware and stuff like this, they are well tested, they are running all over the world. There is a lot of development behind it.
Getting that all right is quite an orchestra, but it will inevitably create the most performance for the car and also provide the safeguards for reliability of the systems.
The reliability is especially important for races like this here in Le Mans. It's 24 hours, so the components have to last, which is sometimes a struggle, but this is why you put yourself into reliable components, and this is key for such races.
So my opinion is collaboration is key. Collaboration between the OEMs and between the supplier. And that is something which is very strong in this series. And I think one part for sure it's technology, but the biggest part is also collaboration to make this possible.